Like and subscribe right now. Otherwise, you'll have bad luck for the next week. As science develops, humans are proceeding with a plan to resurrect extinct animals. In this video, we will look at creatures that might be dangerous to humanity if they were revived. Like all animals, even if they had lived until now, the fact is that a single gunshot would be fatal. Could you fight this animal one-on-one without any weapon and win? The name of this animal is Smilodon. It lived in the early Pleistocene to early Holocene period, representing the saber-toothed cat, not in the Paleozoic era. Some YouTuber explained it as if it was from the Paleozoic era. The characteristic of Smilodon is that it has large, long canine teeth. Because of its name, saber-toothed tiger, most people think it has a well-balanced body structure like other cat species. However, surprisingly, Smilodon has a skeletal structure similar to that of a hyena. Its front legs are particularly stronger than its hind legs. Because of that, it is speculated that it had less jumping ability and agility. In fact, an experiment using Smilodon's skull showed that its biting force was lower than that of a large dog. However, the scariest thing about Smilodon is its stabbing. In South America, a fossil was found of a Smilodon skull being pierced by those canines. Moreover, its front paws are extremely solid, so once it grabs you, those canines will go right in. Because it's much larger than a tiger, ordinary people would be eaten if they encountered one. Recently, there was an incident in Assam, India, where a single tiger came down to the village. Because of that one tiger, the entire village was in an evacuation uproar. In fact, the villagers still have a hard time going out at night. If just a single tiger causes this much pressure, imagine if Smilodon were truly alive and moving around. Your body would freeze up. Above all, thanks to its jaw joint, it could open its mouth up to 130 degrees. It's similar to the more recently extinct thylacine. There is even a possibility that they lived in groups, like lions or hyenas living in Africa, for example.
If they bite their tongue while eating, it would get pierced through.
What is this talk about a tongue piercing? Don't say such scary things. Smilodon is an animal I've loved since I was 8 years old. If it could be resurrected, I really would like to see it once. Recently, a 35,000-year-old saber-toothed tiger cub mummy was discovered for the first time in the world. This is a photo of the frozen mummy of a saber-toothed tiger cub that lived on Earth 35,000 years ago, revealed this time. Maybe this mummy could be the key to seeing the saber-toothed cat again someday? Have you ever seen this giant mammal from the Eocene of ancient China called Gojingi? Its name is Andrewsarchus. When its skull was first discovered, it was an astonishing 83 centimeters in length. At that time, it was estimated to be 3.8 meters in body length and 1.9 meters tall. So it was thought to be the largest carnivorous mammal in Earth's history. Recently, it has been revealed that it was similar to whales and hippos. It's not classified as a carnivoran, but in the order Artiodactyla. However, some people still depict it as similar to a wolf or hyena. This is because only its skull has been discovered so far, and none of its body fossils have been found. We cannot accurately estimate its size. It's assumed to have had a powerful jaw and sharp teeth, and to have been mostly carnivorous. It is thought to have mainly played a scavenger role, feeding on the carcasses of other animals. But even now, hippos have teeth twice the size of a T-Rex's canines, right? Plus, a hippo's jaw strength is considered the strongest among mammals. If Andrewsarchus were resurrected and chased after you, maybe it would feel like this. Of course, today's hippo is an herbivore, so it's a bit different. Wait, so that means Andrewsarchus is a carnivorous hippo. That's scary just imagining it. But in reality, hippos today, when there's nothing else to eat, sometimes eat carcasses, even of their own kind. This is the sound of Andrewsarchus that a foreign YouTuber recreated. To all my viewers, listen and comment on which animal you think it resembles. A consistently restored animal that humans have tried to bring back since ancient times is the woolly mammoth, Among mammoths, the woolly mammoth is the most famous, appearing in the mid-Pleistocene and surviving until the Holocene. Because of that, traces of woolly mammoths are occasionally discovered. Therefore, many researchers have collected somatic cells from frozen mammoths and are planning on nuclear transfer with an Asian elephant's egg whose nucleus has been removed. Then it will have 99.5% mammoth DNA and 0.5% Asian elephant DNA. But recently, a frozen baby woolly mammoth that died in the Ice Age was found. Experts say it is the most complete woolly mammoth they have ever seen. The DNA of these woolly mammoths brings their restoration one step closer. So in March of this year, an American bio company succeeded in developing elephant stem cells, a key step in mammoth restoration. Even more surprising, this company stated they will bring to life an elephant-like woolly mammoth by 2028. Eventually, their ultimate goal is to create a herd of woolly mammoths and release them in the Arctic tundra region.
We can get so much information from just one fossil and even restore it. So amazing.
Right. But personally, since African elephants are still poached for their tusks, if woolly mammoths were alive today,
poaching might be even worse for their fur or tusks.
We humans are sorry.
Did you know there was a sloth the size of an elephant? This sloth, which could smack Smilodon away, is called Megatherium. To be precise, it's a ground sloth, not the tree sloth, which lived from the Pliocene to the Pleistocene. Its body length is 6 meters, shoulder height is 2 meters, and it is estimated to weigh up to 5 tons. The claw structure is similar to that of today's anteaters. It walked on all fours, but it could also stand on 2 legs, kind of like pandas or gorillas. Since it was so large, if it grew to adulthood, it likely had no natural predators. Modern sloths mostly live in trees. On the other hand, Megatherium lived on the ground. It's presumed that it stood on its 2 legs to reach leaves in high places. Although it's mainly known as herbivorous, some scholars suggest Megatherium also ate small animals. What's really scary is that it had sharp and powerful claws on its front limbs. If you look at today's sloths, their claws are terrifying. It likely used these claws to acquire food or to defend itself from enemies. Many fossils are preserved in a complete state because Megatherium is a relatively recently extinct creature. It greatly contributes to research on past ecosystems. Still, running into a sloth of that size in the forest would be scarier than a bear, I think. In fact, traces show that Megatherium coexisted with ancient humans in South America at that time.
Wow, if we hunted, it would probably taste incredible.
Not sure if Megatherium would taste good. Or you would.
Wait a minute.
Among already extinct animals, there are some that still generate sightings up until today, 2025. Have you heard of that? It's Plesiosaurus. It's a long-necked marine reptile discovered in the early Jurassic period in the UK. It can reach up to 3.5 meters in length and weigh up to 185 kilograms. Famous cryptids like the Loch Ness Monster, the Bear Lake Monster, or the Brazno Lake Dragon all share similar traits
with Plesiosaurus.
Check out this video. There's a mysterious long creature swimming at a high speed in the middle of the ocean. It really resembles the Loch Ness Monster.
Experts say it's not a whale.
Ah, my bad. I was swimming for a moment back then.
You're just a swimming pig. From what I see, it could be a sea turtle, beluga, or sturgeon. However, people love Plesiosaurus, Kronosaurus, Pliosaurus, and other ancient marine reptiles. Above all, humans cannot live in the ocean. The curiosity about undiscovered marine creatures still makes people wonder if some long-necked reptile like Plesiosaurus could be alive. Coelacanths and chambered nautiluses, once thought to be extinct, were found alive in the sea, after all. Perhaps, albeit a very slim chance, Plesiosaurus-like marine reptiles still breathe deep in the ocean. Realistically, if Plesiosaurus were to be revived, it would become the top predator in the marine ecosystem. But the food supply might be insufficient, throwing off the balance. And above all, humans would probably turn it into a tourist attraction, or lock it up in a zoo. Have you heard of the largest theropod dinosaur, Spinosaurus? After Jurassic Park 3, it made a big name for itself among dinosaur enthusiasts due to its rivalry with Tyrannosaurus. Surprisingly, a complete skeleton of Spinosaurus has not yet been discovered. Hence, its restored appearance keeps changing. At the time of its discovery, the skull was 1.75 meters long, and the body was about 18 meters long and weighed about 20 tons. It was the largest land-dwelling carnivorous animal in Earth's history. Experts were astonished. However, in 2022, a recalculation was made, and it got a balance patch. Its length was revised to 14 meters, weighing 7.4 tons. As a result, Tyrannosaurus regained the title of the largest carnivorous dinosaur in terms of size. Even so, it remains the longest theropod. With a snake-like long neck, a slender snout, and dense teeth, it resembles a crocodile. It's thought it tore its prey by grabbing and shaking it around, like a crocodile does. It even had neurovascular openings in the snout to sense vibrations in the water, just like crocodiles. This means Spinosaurus hunted in the water as well. It was the apex predator, both on land and in the water. The most iconic feature of Spinosaurus is the sail-like neural spines on its back, and we still don't know its purpose. Experts speculate it was for temperature regulation, display, or fishing. Even more amazing is that we still don't know if Spinosaurus walked on two legs or four. Recently, there is a suggestion that it might have been capable of both, like bears, gorillas, or kangaroos. In the water, it might have used its front limbs for four-legged walking, and on land, it walked on two legs. For those who know a lot about Spinosaurus, please let me know in the comments. Do you know which marine creature God deleted for being too imbalanced? It's Megalodon. It's the largest fish in Earth's history and was the apex predator of the ocean at the time. Just looking at the size of today's great white shark, you can imagine how huge Megalodon was. It appeared in the early Miocene and became extinct in the early Pliocene. But fossils have been discovered all over the world to this day. Fossils have even been found in the deepest part of the world, the Mariana Trench, and in places like Pohang and Jeju Island in Korea. It truly roamed all the seas of the Earth. Being the largest carnivorous shark in history, it's estimated to have reached 20 meters in length and weighed about 103 tons. This tooth is one of the largest megalodon teeth ever found. Just one tooth is 20 centimeters. Roughly calculating from this tooth size, it could swallow a human whole, fitting up to 5 people in its mouth. Then, what caused this colossal sea creature, Megalodon, to go extinct? At that time, it roamed the seas alongside Leviathan. However, it went extinct 36 million years ago. Various theories exist. One is that whale diversity and populations decreased, so there wasn't enough food. Additionally, climate change and the emergence of new competitors are possible reasons. Surprisingly, medium to large sharks, like great whites, became powerful competitors for Megalodon. As the prey got smaller, smaller sharks had the advantage in hunting. Naturally, the gigantic and slow Megalodon went extinct.
As expected, it's not the strong who survive, but those who survive the longest who are strong.
Right. I don't know how fish survived back then. Seeing how nature has evolved and decayed for such a long time, it makes me realize how short my life is. I hope you, my viewers, will create memorable histories with your loved ones in your own lives. I'd appreciate it if you could also hit the like button.